Now we're going to go ahead and adjust the valve clearance. Here we have a spark plug galley for cylinder one. And it's important to know what your firing order is for your car when you go ahead and adjust your valve clearance. Now, this is maybe weird or hard to wrap your head around. Just play with the motor here. The motor will tell you everything you need to know. So what we want to do is we want to time the motor so that the intake valves and the exhaust valves, and we know that these are the intake valves because the intake sits on top of the engine and draws air in to our cylinders and our piston compresses, etc., you know, four-stroke routine. And then the exhaust ports open up and the exhaust comes out the bottom. So we have our intake valves and our exhaust valves. And what we're going to do is we're going to adjust those clearances right here. You can see how this nut loosens up here. And there's a little screw hole right there too. So that will allow, you can see this screw, this is a big screw here, adjusting the valve clearance. And then once we get it to where we want it, we're going to tighten that down. It's going to be a little concerted effort. We're going to use the screwdriver and the 10 millimeter wrench in concert with one another. What we're going to need for this is a flathead screwdriver, a 10 millimeter wrench, and some feeler gauges. And the feeler gauges go in between. You can see how this clicks and rattles. Well, that's part of where you get this click and rattle from. When your car's on, it can make it sound kind of like a diesel. So what you want to do is have the clearances on the intake and the exhaust set so that they don't rattle. And you want to look up the specs for your vehicle, but I found that my vehicle, right in the middle is, and I'm going to go metric again on you guys, right in the middle for the intake clearance is 0.2 millimeters. We'd stick this in between and then adjust that tightness and get that clearance set and then lock it down with this nut again. Now we have to do that when the engine is in the proper, where each cylinder has the piston in the proper part of the compression and the proper part of its stroke. So what we need to do is we need to take a look at our camshaft sprocket here again. And what you'll notice is that you've got this little timing mark here. We use that when we set up the timing belt. But what you want to use is this arrow, which is right in here. And that arrow tells us where the piston is at. So if I go ahead and rotate around the engine, you can see that arrow changes position. Okay, so the arrow changes position. But now how do I know that when the arrow is in a certain position, what position the engine is in? The arrow corresponds to where it's at in the stroke. This engine, being that it's a four-cylinder, it fires every 90 degrees. So we can expect that every 90 degrees, we have a cylinder going off. But wait, we don't really know if that is the case. We don't know if that's true. We're unsure. Maybe putting the timing mark at 12 o'clock for cylinder one equals top dead center. That's not the case. Top dead center is actually this arrow here. And the way you can test that, what I'm going to do is rotate the engine. And we're going to go fully around. All right, so now my mark is here. That arrow is here. And if I put my hand over the spark plug galley here, I can feel the piston compress the air up against my hand. And listen to this hiss. All right, and where does the hiss stop? Well, it's almost right exactly at the 12 o'clock position. Now this engine is supposed to be 1-3-2-4 firing order. The way that the pistons are labeled, it's piston 1, piston 1, piston 2, 3, and 4. The timing or the firing order of this engine is 1, 3, 2, 4. That's the number, that's the order in which the engine gives a spark to these cylinders. Well, I don't know if I trust that. I don't know if I believe that or not. So let's go ahead and verify that. So here we have the motor, and we've already felt when the arrow goes to 12 o'clock, this one stopped hissing. I'm gonna put my hand on this one now, because this one should be, cylinder 3 should be the second one in the firing order. And I feel the pressure building, and it stops hissing about there, which is almost 90 degrees, right about. And listening to it hiss or feeling the pressure is not very scientific, so we're just going to go with exactly 90 degrees by looking at it. Coming over here, we're going to do the same thing. Cylinder 2 should be the third one to go. I can feel pressure building and the hiss, and then cylinder number 4, pressure building and the hiss. So that confirms that our firing order is 1, 3, 2, 4. We want to set cylinder 1, piston 1, at the top of its stroke, at its highest compression. That's what we want for this. So here we go. Feel the pressure building. And right there we are at, we're in the money right there. I've got to set my intake valves to 0.2 millimeters. So I'm going to do that to both of these top ones here. All right, and you tighten it down. And then I'm going to test my clearance here, and it's still nice and taut. I feel a little bit of grab, and it pulls through. All right, so now when I slide this in, I can still pull it out. There's a little bit of click left in it. That should be good. Now this one, it's just blowing in the wind. So what we're gonna do, set it down there. Back that off. And that felt pretty good, so I'm gonna tighten it down just a little bit and drop that in there, and I get the nice little kind of snug pull out there. Little bit of click, little bit of click. Exhaust, gonna be 0.25. Let's go ahead and get these backed off. All right, those are gonna be blowing in the wind. And let's just see what that looks like. Wow, like a hot dog down a hallway. All right, so we're gonna stick our 0.25 down in there. I can feel that's too tight, so I'm just going to back it off until I feel that start to give. All right, too tight. Just a couple degrees on that screw is all it really takes. All right, and let's see how she does here. So that's pretty good and snug. All right, let's check both of them. All right, nice and... Got a little bit of slide, a little bit of grab. Check this one here, and... Same kind of thing, little slide, little grab. All right, let's rotate the engine over to the next position. We're in 12 o'clock here. which is top dead center for the first piston. Now let's go to the third piston, which is going to be top dead center, exactly 90 degrees over, and we can feel that, make sure it, it is hissing, and we are still hissing, and right about there. Now I did see some people, they actually go all the way around and then they check their valve clearances. Again, here. So why don't we just go ahead and do that? Back to the 2.2, and oops, well, that's definitely snug. That's good and snug. And just that one here. All right. Exhaust. Exhaust checks out. Intake checks out. We got our valve cover here. We put our valve cover gasket inside. Kind of smooshes into place. Make sure that our edge here is clean. And then our valve cover gasket's clean. And this just kind of plops right down like this. What you'll notice is there's a lot of wiggle room here. That's because your valve cover bolts have this nice metal ridge on them. You can see the small nut that screws in, and then this thick part, just screw this in here to illustrate. So here I've gone ahead and screwed in the valve cover bolt. You'll notice that there's that big thick portion of the bolt. That's actually what goes through the hole there, and it actually holds the valve cover in place. If you're trying to put that on there and then you feel like there's no real indexing point, that's because these bolts index the valve cover where it needs to be based upon these locations. Kind of blow out any kind of dust or whatever it might be in there. And just go ahead and get this started. And what I'm doing here is just tightening these up in a star pattern. Starting with the middle and going out from there. And you'll notice that once you start getting one set tightened up, it loosens the other one. These do not have to be very tight. You're talking 6 or 7 or 8 foot-pounds. I forget what the exact spec is, but not very tight at all. And I'm just looking down on the top here, and I'm seeing that I only have a little bit of threads left. And I'm going to kind of use that as a You'll judge to tell where I need to be at with my torque, because it doesn't take a whole lot to smush that gasket down and get your seal. And I imagine with these bolts, it wouldn't take a whole lot to strip the cam caps out. So we're not going to do that. We're going to call well enough good here. And let it lie. I can see my gasket smushed around nicely. No more threads. Looking good. Here we have an EJ25, specifically an EJ253 from a 07 Subaru Impreza 2.5i. And that being said, it's almost ready to go back in the car. Valves are clearanced, valves are clearanced, the thing is timed. Now we just need to get it off this engine stand. And gotta seal up the two holes on the back here of the engine, put the clutch back on, and then it needs to go back in the car. So thanks for being around, and good things are coming.